never knows the time or space. Don't cry for me. Happy birthday to you. May you live to see many more. You are 83 years old today. Happy birthday. All right.
Just say it, Mama. Just say it. Just put it to your mouth as though you're drinking it.
Birthday to you. Only one of my ones singing, dude?
Yeah.
All right. Hip hip. All right, the first door. Hip hip. Everybody. Hip hip. Hooray. Hip hip. Hooray. Another 83. You know, Mama, you're going far. Yes, right.
Like for her right now in the mighty name of Jesus, dear Lord. Oh, come on, see, come on, say, oh, shut that, rush, shut that, and oh, yes, Lord, I'll let you know, pray upon her right now in the mighty name of Jesus, dear Lord. That she might live to see many more years to come in the mighty name of Jesus. And I call it done in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
resurrection, and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the living and the dead. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms."
We will now sing the hymn 223, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Friends, family, sons, brother, nieces, nephew, countrymen, countrywomen, and to everyone here today, far and near. As I mentioned, my name is Ronald Clarke. I'm the last brother of 11. I'm Ordene's last brother. I was charged with this magnificent and unenviable task of speaking on behalf of the family about Ordene Carol Taylor Clarke. I want to say also that although it's a sad occasion, it's good to be back among all these folks here in these hollow walls. I left here in 1976, and I was an altar boy here, and I used to come to church every Sunday. So I want to say again, I was raised by everyone in here, all these Philippians. You all made me. So I want to say that, and Ordene made me. And today, I just want to talk about the three L's on behalf of Ordene. Life, living, and love. And you all knew what these mean. In life, Ordene Taylor was born in East Point, St. Philip, to the proud parents of Henry and Marion Clarke. We later moved to Marleyville, St. Philip. Ordene's life and her job in life was to take care of her family and to support her husband, the late Carl Taylor, better known as Cali. They had a special relationship from day one. Ordene never worked outside of the home. She was a housewife and sometimes did farming in the back of her house. She grew vegetables, sheep, cows, pigs, while she took care of her family. And let's not forget her cooking, which she did for everyone in the family and those of you here today who are blessed with her food. I will speak on her cooking further. I can just talk about the little love at this moment. Ordene was a simple but complex person at the same time. She could be very nice to you at one moment, but in the next moment, she would tell you off or correct you. In her own words, directly. She did not play when it came to politics, and everybody in Barbados knows about politics. You know, we have different sides, different views, but she was very passionate about her politics. Ordene seemed to know everything, even medicine, for which myself and Ordene had many debates. To put it lightly, I will tell her that I was going to put down the phone, because she was not a doctor, I was a doctor. But these debates never interfered with our special relationship of brother and sister. Ordene was very truthful. That's one thing about Ordene, very truthful. When her dearly beloved son, Carol, passed from a stroke, I told Ordene that it was probably malpractice since it was felt that he was sent home from the hospital too soon. As much as Ordene loved Carol, she quickly shut my mouth up by letting me know that in no uncertain terms that it was Carol's fault. She said that after he passed, they found all of his blood pressure medications under the bed and the bottles untouched. This was Ordene, the truthful person in life, who did not mince or mix words. Due to the time constraint, let's move on to the next letter, which is love. Ordene love for her family and friends. She loved her kids and her husband. She told me when I was here in October that she was going to see her son, Carol, and her husband. And that's how much she loved them. She was not worried about fighting for her life or her failing health. She did not try to stay alive. The bell had tolled, and she knew that it was time. She loved her friends and family, as testified by this letter. and also by this large congregation here today. This speaks testimonial to her love. On behalf of the family, I want to say that your presence and support here is very revealing. Also, thanks to everyone who is watching from afar this funeral, streaming live on YouTube. Again, thank you all. I will now share some special stories about her love. As a little boy, Ordene and her husband, Callie, every weekend, every Sunday, would pick up the family and take us driving around Barbados. Everybody remember Callie's car, P874. And as a little boy, I look forward to leaving St. Philip, driving down to St. Michael, driving down to Bridgetown, driving all over Barbados, and having a wonderful time. That's the love that she had for the family. Ordene and Callie's love was unsurpassed. I remember when the East Coast Road was being built, they picked us up and took us down to the East Coast Road and drove us until you couldn't drive any further where the road was still being built. And then we came back across Barbados back to St. Philip. That memory is etched in my mind forever. I could never forget it, because that was quite a project that was being done here in Barbados in those times. As a little boy, I also went to camp at the drill hall. And I already had Callie take me to drill hall with a valise, a suitcase, and drop me off. We called it a valise back in those days. And when the camp was over, who came to pick me up was Callie. I remember also when I was running for Barbados, I would take the Route 10 Bayfield bus to come home at night when we trained at Harrison College. And one night I missed the Route 10 Bayfield bus and had to take Route 11. And I got off in Long Bay. So you know it's a good walk. I got the con booth and I called Ordene, and a few minutes later, Callie was there to pick me up. That is the kind of love that Ordene had. Now, the biggest one I want to tell you about is when I was doing my master's, I had to get some money. We went to Raleigh Bank to get the money. I remember that Ordene and my dad had said that if he had to sell his house to pay for my education, he would do that. And both Ordene and Grant said, look, you're getting your master's, we take care of this. They went to Raleigh Bank and mortgaged their house to get me a loan to do my master's. The banker said, boy, you know you're lucky. No one else will do this for you. And I sit there quietly and said, she doesn't know her family, this unconditional love in the family. That's the type of person Ordene was. So, I have friends here from the United States. And some of my friends stayed here from Adelphi University. Roberta Cooper, he was trying to be here, but couldn't get a flight. And there was one of them, Terry Jackson. Terry Jackson, after he spent time with Ordene, went back to the States. And he told his mother, Mom, I want you to cook like Ordene. I don't want any salt and pepper chicken. I want the chicken sliced, and I want to see the green seasoning in chicken and then fried. That's the kind of impact that she had on people. I'm going to read from Dr. David Parris, who also came with his mom from St. Kitts Nevis, and he was getting a visa for his mom to the States, and he stayed with us. He said, although it is difficult today to see beyond the sorrow, grief is the price we pay for our love. We all love you. Looking back at all the wonderful memories you gave to us will comfort you tomorrow. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for the unconditional love, caring unsurpassed, generosity, and tremendous support that you have given to me and my entire family when you embraced us without any hesitation or question. Just the mere words of your beloved brother, Dr. Ronald Clarke, I became an immediate family member. Sleep, my dear, until we meet again. Or please, have some of your delicious dishes ready for me. And I have a whole list of remarks from different people. I'm just going to pick a few due to time's constraint. It says, a great lady that fed me when I was hungry. I didn't know her, but when I went to Barbados, she welcomed me as her own child and chastised me, typical Ordene, for not eating all of her delicious food that she put in front of me. She was a mother figure to all her siblings, the one that always said that my sister or that in my brother, and you will not talk bad about them. Those were words whenever one of their children complained to her about something they weren't pleased with. Then in the same breath, she would call the sibling in question, and that's why you're troubling so-and-so. Stop it, Everton, Ronald, and Diana. She always said that all of you were her gifts from your parents and her best friends. To her nieces and nephews, she loved you like a mother kept your secrets like a sister. All of you had held a special place in her heart. So to Sammy, Gina, and Everton, remember that. Karen, just know to her you were a gift to her that her heart will never ever know. Her appreciation for you is everlasting. Ethan, you became her main man, the head of the household, and you brightened her life. Always remember you were her garden of flowers that grew in her heart. To her special friends, Alicia, Ansel, Judy, Merlin, Marcia, Margot, Bernard, Sparrow, and Deidre, remember, a good head and a good heart are always a formidable combination. These thoughts are hers from the bond between you and her. And I can keep going on and going on, but I'm going to divert off here a little bit because it goes on forever. I would like to continue telling you all the stories, but again, like I said, due to the time constraints, I'm going to go to living. Ordene lived a great life. She lived her life to the max. Ordene liked traveling. And I remember her and Gwen, they traveled everywhere. They went to Puerto Rico, Trinidad, United States, went to New York, they went to Atlanta, they went to Mobile. They used to go to the casinos, and I don't know what they did there, but they went to casinos. Ordene's favorite place here in Barbados was Lucky Horseshoe. And she was always that Lucky Horseshoe. And when I came home on my vacation, she took me to Lucky Horseshoe. She, like I said, she loved her. Every time I came home, Ordene was always there at the airport to make sure I got off safely. And the last time I saw her was in, as I said, in early October. And again, she hugged me and she kissed me. And I knew based on that kiss that Ordene was in a special place, that she was in heaven. She wasn't here in Barbados anymore. She told me she was going to be with her husband and her son. So today, folks, I don't think that we should be crying and mourning Ordene's passing. We should be celebrating her life and her honoring, and we should be honoring her. Ordene is with the Lord, and she was with all our family, our parents, brothers, sisters, and everyone here from in St. Philip who knew her. So let's wish Ordene good speed and farewell, and may she rest in peace. And I want to say thanks to everyone here today and everyone watching worldwide who is streaming. We want to thank you for sharing and for Ordene for having shared her life with you. And thank you all, everyone.
Amen. We'll now have a tribute by Marcia Burke.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. I am the adopted family member of Mumma. She was Mumma for almost everyone, but she was my Mumma. And whenever I go to her home, she would cup my face in her hand and say, "I too love you." So this one is for Mumma. Remember, I am not a songbird. I'm not a Rihanna. So So please bear with me and bear in mind that this is for Mama. When Jesus sent you to us, we love you from the start. You were just a bit of sunshine from heaven to our hearts, not just another lady, 'cause since the world began, there's been something very special for you in his plan. That's why he made you special. You're the only one of your kind. God gave you a body and a bright, healthy mind. He had a special purpose that he wanted you to find. So he made you someone special. You're the only one of your kind. You were someone special every day in every way. God was always by your side every day of every year. That's why he made you special. You're the only one of your kind. God gave you a body and a bright, healthy mind. He had a special purpose that he wanted you to find. So he made you someone special. You're the only one of your kind. Rest in peace, Mama. We love you.
Please stand, Father Collette. Please be seated for the first Bible reading by Ari Butcher.
A reading from Revelation chapter 21, verse 1 to 7. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And he heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and there shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." And he that sat upon the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said unto me, "Write, for these words are true and faithful." And he said unto me, "It is done. am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. He endeth the reading.
The choir will now render the Crimean version of Psalm 23.
Good evening. My name is Michelle Taylor, and I am Arden's daughter-in-law. The second reading is taken from John 14, verses 1 to 6. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, what I have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. the word of the Lord. Thank you.
We'll now stand and sing hymn 236, O Lord my God.
Thank you. From where I was sitting, I could hear a little bit about Today we might just that we should live lives that are wholesome, lives that add favor to the world, a life that leaves a legacy that can be mentioned. My brothers and sisters, most important of all, a life that is promised in Christ Jesus. Mark
the opportunity in this service of thanksgiving to return.
We'll now repeat the Apostles' Creed as found on page 5 in our leaflets. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and was born of the Virgin Mary. Please remain standing for the prayers of intercession.
Let us pray. We pray for those who mourn. We commemorate the departed Ordene Carol. Your response to the petition shall be, hear our prayer. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy. Be close to those who mourn. Increase the faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy. May we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy. Show your mercy to the dying, strengthen them with hope, and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy. We commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled, and we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we share with them in your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
We now have the commendation. Thy way, not mine, O Lord.
Thank you.
Now, the meters.
Thank you. above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. You were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known. Above all wealth
and treasures of the earth. Happy birthday.
There's no way to measure what you're worth.
Just say it, Mama.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all things.
I upon her right now in the mighty name of Jesus, that she might live to see many more years to come in the mighty name of Jesus. And I call it down in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Still
Mama gave it to her.
But that's what somebody's going to do it for number two.
So, Eddie, treat for this.
Yeah. Practice, man, perfect.
She's all I got, you know.
All right.
Practice math
perfect. 83. Happy birthday to you. May you live to see many more. You are 83 years old today. Happy birthday. All right. Just say it, Mama. Just put it to your mouth as though you're drinking it.
Let me tell Mama
Birthday to you. Only one my one singing do. All right.
Hip hip.
All right, the first was hip hip. Everybody. Hip hip. Hooray. Hip hip. Hooray. Another 83. You know, Mama, you going far. Yes. Right.
Amen.
Yeah.
Mama gave it to us. Yeah.
But that's somebody's going to do it for them too. Yeah.
God. Right. So, 83 for this.
Yeah. Practice man perfect.
All right.
Practice man perfect.
83. Mama, happy birthday to you. May you live to see many more. You are 83 years old today. Happy birthday. All right. Just put it to your mouth as though you're drinking it. Birthday to you. Only one might want singing, do it? Yeah. All right.
Hip, hip.
All right, the first was hip, hip. Everybody. Hip, hip. Hooray! Hip hip! Hooray! Another 83, you know, Mama, you going for? Yes, right.
Like for her right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, come on, see, come on, don't shut that down, rush that down. Oh, you're not going to let her right now in the mighty name of Jesus. That she might live to see many more years to come in the mighty name of Jesus. And I call it done in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Still
again. Yeah, 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 yeah.
But there's somebody's going to do it for them too. Yeah.
God. Right. So 83 for this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Practice man perfect.
Yeah, yeah, she's all I got, you know.
All right. Yeah. 83. Mama, happy birthday to you. May you live to see many more. You are 83 years old today. Happy birthday. All right.
Yeah, you want it?
No, you drink it. Just say it, Mama. Just say it. Just put it to your mouth as though you're drinking it.
Let me tell Mama you're going. You want it, Yeah.
Birthday to you. Only one might want singing, though. Yeah. All right.
Hip, hip.
All right, the first was hip, hip. Everybody. Hip, hip. Hooray. Hip, hip. Hooray. Another 83. You know, Mama, you're going far. Yes, right.
Like for her right now in the mighty name of Jesus, oh, come on, see, come on, stand, oh, shut that, rush, shut that, and oh, yes, Lord, I'll let you know, stand upon her right now in the mighty name of Jesus, that she might live to see many more years to come in the mighty name of Jesus. And I call it down in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
To be.
Mama get instructions.
I will trust in you. Truth is, you know what tomorrow brings. There's not a day ahead you have not seen. So when I want what you want, Lord, and nothing less. When you
Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence, there's fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this. Happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for we take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our heart. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
Jesus, over every heart and every mind, 'cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus. Jesus, till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak to you.
And so now, in the quiet of this moment, we prepare to commit her body to the earth. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend our sister, Ordene Carol, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Ordene, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen.
Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I've been set free, no need to fear. God spoke to me, my time had come. He made a way to bring me home. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. I saw the light, I took his hand. We flew on high to the promised land. My soul lives on in a better place, with all his glory, with all his grace. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. My pain is gone, please understand. My passing was in God's great plan. I'm with you still, each day and night. Just close your eyes, I'll hold you tight. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. I'm in your heart, I feel your pain. Don't give up hope, our love remains. I'll wait for you at heaven's door. We'll meet again one day for sure. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me,
We'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I've been set free, no need to fear. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul.
The Lord be with you. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, humbly we pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce, "Come, ye blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world." Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirit shall sorrow no more, not a sigh for the blessing of rest. In the sweet
by and by,
we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet
by and by,
we shall meet on that beautiful shore. To our bountiful Father above, we will offer a tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that hallow our days.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, to her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. And unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. Thank you.
Mama Gaines from church.
But there's somebody is going to do it for the two.
Right. So 83 for this.
Practice man perfect.
All right.
Practice man perfect.
83.
I love you to
detect. Happy birthday to you. May you live to see many more. You are 83 years old today. Happy birthday. All right.
Just say it, Mama.
Just put it to your mouth as though you're drinking it.
Birthday to you.
Only when my one singing, do it? Yeah. All right.
Hip, hip.
All right, the first was hip, hip. Everybody. Hip, hip. Hooray. Hip, hip. Hooray. Another 83. You know, Mama, you're going far. Yes, right.
It's time to sing your song.